to No Name. That No Name may know where it is, and No Name may keep the gateway. But it's very cryptic what it means. It's almost like in the middle of a poem.
So we need to find out more about this No Name.
And the professor says, this is strange. It couldn't be that little man who lives down near the swamps. That couldn't be him. It couldn't be the same No Name as in this old book.
Maybe he would know something about it, though.
Maybe it's descendant of the original No Name.
Yeah, if you go, it's south of town. It's about 15 miles. And, the ground, it gets kind of swampy, and there's a big lake there. And some farmland area. And he's very reclusive. He only comes into, the village occasionally to make some trades on some very rare occasions. But he mostly keeps to himself. We're not even sure how he survives out there, if he's doing it all on farming. Little man, about the size of a halfling, but much, much skinnier and kind of crooked. Doesn't look like any halfling I had ever seen.
Well, we could pay him a visit. Can you point it out on your map to us where we should go?
Okay, so he shows you the map, and kind of if you follow like I said, there's sort of a southeast road out of town, and you have to go over a very large hill, and then when you descend down the hill, you'll descend into his valley. So it's just several valleys over from here. Probably a good day's walk, though.
Well, what do you say, team?
It sounds like if we leave pretty quick, we might be able to get there by the end of the day. We just have to go find Corlu first.
All right. I'm for that. How about I go over to the tavern and tell him to get his stuff together, and we can meet up at the sheriff's in a half hour.
Sounds like a plan.
Okay. So I head over to the tavern to look for Corlu.
Okay, and you find him there, no trouble.
And I tell him that after talking to the professor, we want to start out on a journey quite shortly, so if he wants to get his stuff together and meet us at the sheriff's ASAP, then we'll head out.
I'm gonna guess most of my stuff was still on the ship unless we unloaded it. But whatever I need to gather, I'll stop and gather, and I tell her, it's a good place to meet because I have some information I want to pass along to the sheriff. And I'll give her the description of the guy and his street name, and that it's kind of rumored around town that he was an accomplice of the people, and it's just they're kind of wondering, maybe he had something to do with it. And I'll repeat that same thing to the sheriff when we get there.
Okay, so you go and you visit the sheriff, and he says, "Oh, that Joe Potato, he was always a small timer. I'm surprised. But again, maybe he was working with Lemmy, or maybe somebody actually wanted to break Lemmy out of here and get him out of town so that they could take over Lemmy and Damiak's spot. I don't know, but we'll definitely keep an eye out for Joe and see when he comes back in town."
All right. And they said they'd keep an eye out for him if they see him. So you obviously know what he looks like. You can tell all the other constables in town to keep an eye out for him. And
oh, absolutely. Like a large, dangerous potato.
All right. So are we ready to head over the hill and through the woods?
Grandmother's house?
Something like that.
Heck yeah.
Yes, I am ready.
All right.
Anything special you guys are, you folks are taking with you?
I'm going to look over my gear. I don't think anything else.
Unless the sheriff has some extra bug spray, because I'm assuming the swamp's going to be nice and humid and sticky and lots of bugs.
Okay, well, they arranged to give you some stuff, some oil to put it, like you could put it with a torch.
Right.
And then
right.
And then you.
We're going into a like a swamp type thing. That's what you said.
Well, it's more of a watershed.
Oh, okay.
More of a watershed, not like
when, yeah.
Not like
when you said. Yeah.
Not like Planet Dagobah.
Well, yeah, but like a wetlands type thing, but
we're if it's flat, it's not too bad, but with the swamp, you usually think humidity and you think lots and lots of bugs.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I want to take some extra water because I'm not drinking anything that we're walking in and stuff slithering around in or whatever.
Slithering.
Yeah, just extra water sounds like a good idea.
I want to grab some torches too. I don't know, whatever they come standard in a box or whatever they are.
Yeah.
Rope flares. I have one, so I'd like some more.
Okay, so you start to head south during that day, and it's starting to get dark as you're coming up the top of a mountain. So you have the choice. You could either camp on the mountain, push through it in the dark, push through and camp down below, you know, whatever you'd like.
I think it would be better to camp up here and see what's coming.
Yeah, sounds good.
Although, of course, if we want to light a fire, it'll be a big signal to everybody, too.
That is true.
However, what's the weather like?
It's getting colder. It's getting colder, you know, it's one of those like in the fall where kind of pleasant in the afternoon while the sun is up, but then the sun goes down and it's, you know, dropping into the lower 50s or whatever unit they use in Fantasyland.
What do you guys think?
About starting a fire?
Do we want to try and push through and then rest?
If it's only going to get down to the 50s, we should be okay. I mean,
we can build a fire.
I don't recommend building a fire on the top of a mountain.
Hit.
Well, we'll head down. How about we head down to the bottom and then we'll camp?
Yeah, because at the top, you basically just, it becomes a beacon.
Right. Yeah. You mean it might attract monsters?
Might attract all kinds of things. Bandits, monsters.
XP.
It's all XP. All right. Well, I guess we'll have a cold camp.
Okay, so you have a very cold night. A little warm fire would have helped. And you camp down the base of the mountain. And you're almost to the base. And then this is the terrain. Can you see the picture I put up here?
Yep.
So to you're heading just like kind of into the picture, and to your right is the mountain. It's kind of steep there. It'd be tricky to climb up. I mean, it could be done, but it's still pretty steep there. And then to the left is a drop off, maybe about 40, 50 feet. And there's a river down below. And a child screaming, but you don't hear that.
So this is the morning now.
So this is the morning. And you start to hear some noise, some rustling.
Coming up river or down river? Across the river.
It seems to be all around you.
So rustling as in, you know, something on the ground coming through some
maybe.
Scrub.
Could be a deer, could be a bear.
I'll go check it out, where at least where I think it's coming from.
Deer or bear sounds like a good meal.
Well, as you're coming there, what you see is coming from up here and actually crawling up from the top. And then from around the corner, you have these three giant pig creatures. So I didn't put your tokens there. If you want to move your tokens on or however you want to do it.
Wow. Did you Photoshop that or did somebody else draw that?
I found that online.
That is a crazy, I don't even know what, but it is crazy looking.
I think it's done from like a prehistoric creature.
Right.
Yeah. A prehistoric creature reconstruction or something.
So you want our tokens on the map you drew?
Yeah, I guess so.
I don't know where mine went.
Okay. Can you see it now? Or no? Oh, it's like when I move them over, they go behind.
Oh.
Let me. Is there a way to bring them to?
Yeah, I see.
Bring to front. There you go. Are you? Did you click bring to? No, you're good. You should be all right. Let me put the map back. And then. Why is it doing that? We're not getting the tokens on that picture. It's having problems. No, there we go. There we go. So I got everybody here, and you just have to pick a piggy.
I guess I'll go for the one that I'm standing behind.
Okay.
They get a sneak attack from behind.
All right. Yeah, he's kind of crawling up, you know, up the hill as best he can. So why don't folks give me a D6 roll?
I got a 6.
Okay. Yeah, so these pigs aren't very subtle. You hear the noise. You know, and they seem like they heard you coming, and they're ready. They're ready for their breakfast.
Want to eat us?
No, and they lost the initiative. They were just way too noisy. So going in dex order is Paolo, Berna, Fandar, Corlu, and Reuven.
All right, I'm going to use the Ring of Animal Control.
Okay.
On the one on the right that nobody's, like, that's farthest away, people.
That's on farthest the on the right. Okay, let me see what his number looks like. Oh, he missed his save. So you have him under control as long as you don't attack or move.
Okay.
Which one?
The one that's all the way on the right at the bottom.
Okay.
In the southeast corner of the map.
In fact, I'll put a C there, so we know he's controlled. So that one is, like I said, he's good until Paolo moves or attacks. And so, how about Berna? What are you doing?
I'm gonna attack the one I'm next to.
Okay, go ahead.
With my axe. I didn't hit it. I rolled a 1.
Okay. So. It jumps back in the last minute, and it's definitely evaded the butcher. So how about Fandar? What are you doing?
I'm attacking with... I have my shield and sword out, and I'm attacking this one.
The one that's all the way on the left there.
Yes.
Yeah, he's almost over the edge. Almost over the edge.
Chop his legs off.
I rolled an 18.
What's that hit? That's, I'm sure that's good enough.
I'm sure it's good enough.
Yeah, it is. So give me a damage roll.
7 + 1, 8 damage.
Okay, great.
Oh, you really hurt him.
He's squealing in pain. How about Corlu? What's Corlu doing?
I got a 12. That'll hit armor class 5.
Uh-huh, and that's good enough.
All right.
So you attack him.
Well, hold on. Is he when we first see this, is he, like, right up on us, or this one's coming up this side of that thing? I want to know is, can I shoot him with an arrow, or is he so close I have to go into sword combat?
No, you could get him with an arrow, because you're a little bit further back than what Fandar is.
All right. So. 3.
Three, okay. 1, 2, 3. So he's slipping on the edge there. He doesn't have a real good grip at this point.
All right.
But we'll have to see what happens next round.